Assalamu alaikum everyone, respected faculty members, students of research and innovation. My name is Zubairuddin Sheikh and I welcome you all in yet another webinar organized by the Learning and Development Wing of Sindh Madrasatul Islam University Teachers Association. Research is the heart of societal as well as academic growth. One can only get so far in terms of knowledge without the proper instrument to prosper in the field of research and innovation. Having said that, I am proud to announce our today's guest speaker, Dr. Asadullah Sheikh. In addition to being an associate professor, Dr. Asadullah Sheikh is also the head of research and the coordinator of seminars and training with the College of Computer Science and Information Systems, Najran University, Saudi Arabia. He has more than 80 publications in the area of software engineering in international journals and conferences. His current research topics are UML model certification, UML class diagrams verification with OCL constraints for complex models, formal verification, feedback technique for unsatisfiable UML or OCL class diagrams. He has worked as a researcher in UOC Barcelona, Spain. He is also the editor of the International Journal of Advanced Computer Systems and Software Engineering and an international advisory board of several conferences and journals. Without further ado, I would like to hand the session over to our honorable speaker, Dr. Asadullah Sheikh. All of the participants are requested to note down their question and send the questions through comment section in our live stream. Assalamu alaikum, sir, and the session is over to you.
Okay, thank you, Zubair Sheikh Saab. I hope I'm clear. Can you hear me, right?
Yes, sir.
Can you hear
yes,
me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, thank you very much for your nice introduction. And I hope my screen is shared and you can see the slides on screen. So let's make this presentation a little bit more interactive. So we will not make so much boring of it. And if there's any question during the presentation, you can type or I don't know if the administrator allows you. And you can ask, then I can also answer you simultaneously. Okay, so what is today's topic? Today's topic, we are going to talk about how to publish the quality of the journal papers and improve the citations, which is one of the basic needs in today's world for applying the promotions, for applying the research funds, for each and every kind of the research era. You need these kind of publications in order to proceed academic career. So let's have a very good example that, for example, if we say how to measure the quality, we will have two kinds of the candies. That is, we say number A and number B. So I don't know if the audience can answer this, but we will ask from the host. That, if I ask a host that would you like to, if you get an option to get the candy A or B to eat, which one you will choose? Host, can you answer me, please?
Yes, sir. Can you repeat the question, please?
I repeat that in your screen, you can see two kinds of candies. There's the one wrapped candies with A, and there's the one open candies, which is B. If I give you an option which you want to eat, which one you will take?
I think A. I will prefer A.
Yes, definitely A. This is exactly how we measure the quality in the journal papers. Okay, the people want to see a complete research which is packed with the phenomena, with the experimental results, with up-to-date complete knowledge. So they will throw like these kind of the candies which you can see on your screen. If I mark it, these kind of the candies are those research papers which are without the complete structure and without their proper knowledge. So these kind of the papers are actually dropped straight away from the journals, and that what we call a desk rejection. So moving ahead, this is how we measure the quality, and we measure the quality one more example. For example, in our Muslim world, we say a good Muslim is who follows the Quran and Sunnah. That we consider it as a quality of a good Muslim. Okay, this is exactly the way the same rules are applying on the journals. We need a standard body against institution authority to check and measure the quality. And this is exactly the ISI Web of Science, Scopus, and all other indexing services are doing for checking their quality. So the term terms that we process are that we say search. We can search anything. Google it, we search anything. This is called search, to find anything. Then we call research. We say research. Research means re-search-definitive. This is means to search again. But the term research without hyphen, it is a systematic investigation to establish the facts. Here we need to understand the facts and figures that we need to explore and publish in the research paper that has not been addressed before. So this is the exactly, we need to understand the difference between search, research, and research. So there are two main types of research that we are talking about, is academic and industrial. There are many publications you will see also from academia, like Volvo, Nokia, Ericsson, and all kind of the vehicle companies are publishing their patents, their research papers to give up-to-date knowledge of the industries. And also there are lots of software houses that they hire researchers to publish their papers, because this become a de facto nowadays to publish the impact factor journals. And without impact factor journals, unfortunately, none of the organization is going to get an recognition. So publication is only one of the several criteria, but it does not prove that someone is a researcher. So when we say a researcher, it means a quality of the research. So this is the sign of the good researcher, that we need to think that how we can identify the good researcher. Good researcher means who has thinking capabilities, who can think right thing on the right time and publish it. For example, this COVID-19 came. Now you will see everywhere the people are publishing COVID-19 papers at a certain time. What will happen? It is exhausted now. There are many, many, many papers that are coming out. But the people who published in the start have gained very good publication from it. So unfortunately, what is happening now? Unfortunately, the publication became a race in every institution. Unfortunately, this is undeniable, which we cannot deny it, that everybody is running for the number of the publication, ISI Impact Factor, because it become the de facto of promotion, of applying the funds and all other. And the people are just talking about numbers. How many publications you had? How many impact factor publications you have? How many Scopus Index publications you have? You see, in all these things, because we already discussed that from assistant to associate professor, you need 10 X category and Y category or W category publications. You cannot be promoted to full professor if you don't have 15 research publications. You cannot apply the funds if you don't have this number of the publication. You are not counted as a good scientist if you don't have publications. It doesn't mean, because some people are very good, but they are not able to express themselves. They are very good researchers. We have seen very good researchers in the world who are the best, who can write the patent, but unfortunately they are not good in the presentation. This race, we forgot the quality, unfortunately. And this is the Almia now, that day by day, impact factor, ISI, all these things are getting business. I will come to that on this level. So you see, some of the statistics I'm going to give you. Factors for affecting and it become the poor quality. We have the high fees journals. Now there are two categories. Number one, the paid journals. Number two is unpaid journals. Unpaid journals, one paper, it will take years. I mean, I remember that last time I published a paper in Software Practices and Experience. It was in Willis. I submitted the paper in 2016 and the paper was online in December in 2018, free. But unfortunately, no one can wait that long because it's too much. So the people are moving towards the high impact factor journals, which are, for example, IEEE Access. Impact factor 3.75. What is the fees? $750. More than 1,000 rupees. Acceptance rate 61.8%. Complexity, impact factor 2.46. Fees 2,200 USD. Almost 300,000 rupees. Acceptance rate 43%. Then we have sustainability, $2,000. Acceptance rate 66.7%. Then we have MPDI. It's an organization by the Switzerland. They are number of the journals and their acceptance rate is 30-40% and acceptance and the fees starts from $1,500 to $2,500, approximately 350 to 400,000. So what was the purpose? And the list go on. Maybe 100 of the journals, 1,000 of the journals, thousands of the journals they have. They make too much money out of it. But unfortunately, they don't pay even a single dollar to the reviewer. So for example, people who are doing research from the Western worlds, in Europe, in America, in Canada, they have the number of funds there, number of funds. And these number of funds, they can pay $2,200 easily because they have the institutional funds, they can pay it. So when they pay it, there are number of the publications submitted everywhere, everywhere in journal. I'm telling you, I submitted one paper at 12 o'clock. My ID was, for example, 1893. After 2 hours, I submitted the N other paper. I noticed in 2 hours, they received more than 200 papers. Now, from where they are going to get the reviewers for that? Of course, there are no such reviewers available who can review much papers for free. So they are sending to the many reviewers known from our friends, from there, here and there. And what they do, they will not review with heart. Of course, they will just bypass it. Reviewers are not really interested to do their job honestly because they are not getting paid. If you are getting $2,000 and if you give them, for example, $30 or $40 per reviewer, he will think he will do the job honestly, but they are not doing it. Reviewers just wanted to review to increase their profit. For example, they get the credit on their ORCID and PubLoans. I hope the most of the people are aware with ORCID and PubLoans. So ORCID and PubLoans are the profiles like Google Scholar where you can see their paper, your papers and profile. One of the example, for example, this is my ID on PubLoans. You can see that they have given me 13 verified reviews. Verified reviews means they send you the first review, then you get the revision, you revised again, then one review to come in PubLoans, it approximately take more than 1 year. So you can see that they give me the revised review for verified reviews 43. And these reviews are all impact factor difference. Okay, and then we have ORCID. In ORCID, you can also see that we have some verified reviews here from the Human Centers Journal Computing by Springer, Journal of Ambiguent Humanized Computer by Springer, a Network Analysis by Springer. So mostly the Springer and elsewhere, these kind of journals are following ORCID, and some of the other journals are following the PubMeds. So here, this way they give you the credit to become the reviewer. Now, quality publication is exactly, you see this image, that you have the paper in your hand and you start working, and these are the real reviewers that will give you a really tough time. Now, very good example I had, that we submitted a one paper, and that is in the online Willis library by the Educational and Practices and Measurements. I think it is more than 1 year, and the paper is still in review. We got almost three reviews so far, but still the paper is under the final review. So what is the moral of story? Moral of story is that they will give you a very tough time when you're targeting a high class journals, but what is the benefit of those high class journals is you will get the number of citations, because the people around the world like very much research which belongs to the quality, and you will get number of the citations for high quality. But unfortunately, it is a very time consuming, which we cannot deny. So coming back to the topic regarding me, I'm also one of the member of you in the race, that I have recently published the paper in related to the, we have developed an app for the hospitals in our country, which we are working right now. And this app was to treat the COVID-19 patients through telemedicine applications by home, from home, because one of the requirements for the COVID-19 patients is isolation. So we have created a tele-COVID, a telemedicine application, mobile and web application for the architectural design using service-oriented architecture. And this paper has been accepted in CMC, Computer Materials and Continua, by Tech Science Press with impact factor 4.8. And assume that how much money we have paid. This paper was around $30 and 30 pages, and we paid almost $3,000 to get this paper done. But since we have the institutional funding, so we really don't care. One of the quality paper that we published is the paper which is the IEEE ACM International Conference on Automated Software Engineering. I'm almost reaching 100 citations to this paper, published in 2010. But this conference has the acceptance ratio 12%. And it took 5 years, 5 attempts to publish this paper. And this is purely my PhD paper for verification-driven slicing technique for UML-OCL model. So I would consider that this paper has given me more tough time than this. Because here, of course, we are publishing the good results, but with high money, with high funds. And here we are publishing a very high impact public results with lower conference registration fees. So PMC, IMC impact factor is 4.8. And the automated software engineering conference acceptance rate is 12%. I would say the publishing in high class conference by ACM, IEEE Computer Society, not IEEE Explorer, IEEE Computer Society and ACM, plus the Springer Lecture Notes Computer Science, these kind of the conferences are much more better then publishing in different impact factor journals. But unfortunately, these conference papers are not counted in your promotion criteria, but definitely it will increase your profile. So do these prove that I'm a researcher and you have to listen it? Absolutely no. It could vary. I've published more than 80 publications, but I would say that I might have some of the publications which are good enough. And rest of the publications are moderate. We are just trying to publish it in the impact factor and all other to complete this race. But it doesn't mean that we are not going to achieve the quality. Quality is extremely important with the quantity. So the quality comes first and the quantity comes later. So now, whatever is it, so now you see that good publishers, what we talk about, good publisher, is elsewhere. The good journals of the elsewhere, acceptance ratio is 15-20%. Springer Nature, acceptance ratio is 10-15%. Willis, have lots of the published journals in Willis, acceptance ratio is 10-15%. And IEEE transactions, acceptance ratio is 5-10%. Of course, it is going to take time, but if there are a good group of researchers can target these kind of the public publishers, you will have an extremely high number of citations and as well as the good reputation every part of the world. So why elsewhere? One of the elsewhere is the journal is called The Lancet. I don't know how many of the people heard about you, about Lancet. The Lancet is the journal by elsewhere, and its impact factor is 60.3. We submitted our COVID paper in this, and still it is under review. I'm not sure it will be accepted, but if it is accepted, this is the one of the biggest life we have ever achieved. The Lancet. This is the 60.3 impact factor. And I would say that your one paper in Lancet will cover your whole research profile and whole of the world will know who you are. This is the one of the top most journal I have ever seen in my whole life. Lancet with 60.3 impact factor. Then other journals, we have Tech Science Press, Hindawi, CRC Press, IEEE, other than transaction. These all journals are easy with means good number of papers, good number of contributions and amount with publication, you can publish in that. So now we can see the quality in two ways. That is a good quality paper and bad quality papers. What usually the researchers do that? Sometimes good quality papers are published in good journals and in bad journals because the most of the researchers are not aware about how to choose the right journal. Regarding this presentation, after I finish it, if anybody wants this presentation, I can share with them or her. So you can, it will help you to choose the right journal. So good quality papers published in good journals and in bad journals, and also the bad quality papers published in the good journal and the bad journals. But from journal point of view, you need to be very, very specific to select the right journal as per the contribution and publish in it. Because I have seen most of the researchers with good paper, they publish in a bad journal and lose research. So be very, very careful. And this is quite confusing because, as I said, you most of the people are losing their researchers then, research publications to publish in bad quality papers. So how we measure the quality right now? Most of the people are aware that we are measuring the quality to publish our paper in a good journals with two indexing services, that are mostly done by announced by the Thomson Reuters. That one is called SCIE, Science Citation Index, and the other is called Science Citation Index Expanded, SCIE. These are the two standards. Any journal falls under this category will be impact factor and will be automatically covered by Higher Education Commission of Pakistan and other most of the countries where they use this publication to apply for the promotion or any research funds. So what is the difference between SCI and SCIE? General citation report offers a systematic objective, critically evaluate the world's leading journal, and they calculate the citations data. They have the data to calculate the citations, number of the papers published in a year, and number of the citations every year. So they have the number of papers, they divide number of the citations, and they calculate the impact factor for the each journal. So by compiling articles cited reference JCR, it helps in measure quality. So these two categories are actually divided into the two main subjects. That is, one is the science and engineering, and other is the social sciences. So the science and engineering and the social sciences. For the science and engineering, mostly they use SCIE, Science Citation Index Expanded, that has more than 3,700 leading scientific and technical journals that covered on the web of science, and they are the part of JCR, Journal Citation Report. And the other are Social Science Citation Index Expanded. These are also the same category as SCIE, but the only difference is that here we cover the social science papers. Okay, so these two categories are already covered in the Web of Science, and the link below, you can access this thing. But this is the paid journal subscription. So usually, I don't know if I can share my screen here in the Google. So what you can see, you just need to write JCR and 2019 PDF, like in the Google, and search this. So you will see, you will find a PDF here by the research get by the several researchers. You upload it. When you upload it, you can download this list. The list, and after this, it is down. This is free. Anybody, of course, you will not be able to see the complete statistics about the impact factor, but I think you will be able to see the complete list of the journals like this. Yeah. So you see that we have the journal name, for example, Nature Reviews, the total citations in 2019. Journal impact factor 74 and the citing score. So you can simply search the journal from this list, and you can see this list has almost 12,515 journals, if I'm able to show you this. So this is free, and you can, for example, if anyone is working in the computer field, you can just find out the search and write computer. So you will sign many for International Journal of Computer Vision, International Journal of the Computer Materials, Computer in Education. You will find out. So you can select the journal from here and search on Google, and then you can see that what is exactly their article processing charges, if they have any fees, or if they are free and open source. So you can search and publish in that journal. So impact factor, as I told you, they are calculating the way, same way, number of the citations per year, number of the papers published per year, they divide it and they calculate it, that how the impact factor is published, and this is the formula for all. So does the quality depend on the choice? Really, it depends your paper, that if your paper quality is good, and you may choose the good publisher. And also some other factors, when you are PhD student, it also depends upon the supervisor's knowledge. That the do supervisor have such knowledge that he can guide you to publish in the proper public proper journal. I believe it is the responsibility of every supervisor since the day one of the meeting with student to tell him about the requirement of the PhD and as well as the publication quality and the journal that they are targeting for. Most of the supervisors are not aware of the Dean standards, and they are giving very tough time to the students. At the end of the day, the students are failing because the supervisors are keep changing their requirement once they learn about the quality. So the supervisors who are there, they must understand this standard. What is SCIE? What is SCI? How we are going to make understand the student? They should give the presentation to the students that what is the quality, understand quality with the 3-factor publication, then we will give you the go ahead to defend and all other. To me, my supervisor in the start of the day, he told me that I want 3 publications for SCIE, JCR impact factor, and I would not let you defend until or unless you are not done. What is SCIE and what is SSCI? You go yourself and understand it, and you need to explore it. So this is the responsibility of the supervisors to understand the quality and convey it to the students. So supervisor's choice, hidden agenda, they measure the quality. It has happened that many good works got rejected, but later it became something revolutionary that there are some good works that are rejected, but when you start polishing this work, you will make understand that it is actually a good revolutionary research. So I will go directly to the writing style now. So the question that you must answer in the paper, because when we are talking about the paper now, it is very important to get something that the paper have unique idea. Get an idea from a paper. Some people, what they do, they read multiple papers. They read paper A and then paper B and combine them and make a paper. So they have usually 3 ideas. They get something, find a flaw, correct it, and go for the enhancement. They read the paper, understand what is the problem, and they try to find the solution of that problem in their next paper. This is number one. Number two, they get an idea from paper A and paper B. They combine the ideas of both papers and write a new paper. Number three, they come up with a solution to a problem that nobody thought of. This is this paper. Number three can be targeted for the high class impact factor free journals. So which one is easiest? I believe the most of the people will say number two, then number one, and then number three. So it's fine. You can adopt any one of the method to come up with a paper as far as you can work uniquely. You are not copying from the paper. You are not copying the from paper A, paper B. You are taking the ideas, mix up to implement some of your ideas, and then merge it and come with a new paper. So now, what is the best way to answer the questions in the paper? That you should know what is the topic. Do you have any problem formulating? It is worth to stream the intelligent minds. Has anybody touched this issue? Is it a new paper? Or the paper has been published before, How is your work contributing something to the research community? Do you have any proof? These kind of the things are the questions that must be answered. Writing style is the most important factor of the paper. I have seen that some people have a very bad idea, but their writing style is very professional, their paper get accepted. I have seen also some people whose idea is the best, but their writing style is very poor and their paper get rejected. Remember one thing, please, regarding the writing style. The writing style should be like this. When you write it, try to read, try to understand the reader mind. That when you start a sentence A, for example, abstract or any other, when the reader starts reading sentence A, he must know what is going coming up next in the sentence B. मैं इसको और उर्दू में रिपीट करूंगा क्योंकि ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट है कि जब एक हम पेपर लिखते हैं तो एक सेंटेंस हम लिखते हैं तो उस सेंटेंस को हमें इस तरह लिखना चाहिए कि जो वो रीडर पढ़े तो रीडर को ये पता चले कि मैं आगे क्या पढ़ने वाला हूँ. इन अदर वर्ड्स, मैं रीडर का माइंड पढ़ रहा हूँ. ठीक है, तो मैंने एब्स्ट्रैक्ट लिखी, एब्स्ट्रैक्ट का एक सेंटेंस लिखा, तो रीडर ये कहेगा कि भाई अब मुझे नेक्स्ट ये चीज मिलनी चाहिए. तो क्या होगा, रीडर को मजा आएगा. क्यों मजा आएगा? क्योंकि वो उसको वो चीज पढ़ने मिल रही है जो वो चाह रहे. एंड ही विल नेवर लीव योर पेपर. यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द रीडर्स माइंड, हाउ ईच सेंटेंस शुड बी कनेक्टेड विद अनदर. हर एक सेंटेंस एक दूसरे सेंटेंस के साथ कनेक्ट होना चाहिए. ऐसा नहीं हो कि एक सेंटेंस ए बता रहा हो और दूसरा एक सेंटेंस जो है ना वो एच बता रहा हो या एफ बता रहा हो. ए के बाद बी आता है तो ए सेंटेंस के बाद रीडर को ये पता होना चाहिए कि मैं बी पढ़ने वाला हूँ. Then he is going to read your paper. This will happen with the same with the reviewer. If you are going to read the reviewer's mind, consider your paper done and it will be published in high class impact factor without any hurdle. So you want the reviewer to control your thinking. You want to control the thinking of the reviewer. This is very, very important point in the writing style. So most of the common structure of the writing you can see on the screen. We have introduction, that comes first. Then we have related work. Then you have a proposal, your proposal. Usually the people give related work before the conclusion. That is also fine. But why I prefer to give a related work on the second point, second section, because after related work, the reviewer will have an idea about the ongoing work and he will understand. Don't forget to write end of the reviewer work, end of the related work, that how your work is different than the previous. I will repeat this in Urdu. Jab aap apna related work likhein, to last sentence related work ka ye hona chahiye. Aapka kaam baki related kaam se कैसे डिफरेंट है, हाउ यू आर डिफरेंट. दिस इज द कंक्लूडिंग रिमार्क, आखिरी सेंटेंस, कंक्लूडिंग रिमार्क्स ऑफ द रिलेटेड वर्क, ताकि रिव्यूअर को ये पता चले कि जो मैं रिलेटेड वर्क में पढ़ के आया हूं, नीचे जो पेपर है वो कैसे डिफरेंट है. देन व्हाट विल हैपन आफ्टर रिलेटेड वर्क, द रिव्यूअर विल जंप टू योर प्रपोजल. व्हेन ही रीड योर प्रपोजल, he already read in the related work how you are doing, so he will not face the difficulty in understanding your proposal. Right, then proof of efficiency, then you have to give some proof, experimental results jisko kehte hain, proof of the efficiency, proof of the analysis, simulation, experimental evaluation, or the proof concept that you need to proof it, which you have given the theory in the proposal, and the comparison with similar alternatives, some kind of the comparison you need to give in the form of the table, in the benchmark or something, and then finally conclusion, the future work. If any PhD student is with us right now, so agar hamare paas koi is waqt PhD student hai jo hame sun raha hai, main usko hamesha ye kahunga ki before you start योर पीएचडी, राइट अ पेपर विद सिस्टमैटिक लिटरेचर रिव्यू, जिसको हम कहते हैं SLR, जो हम क्या करते हैं, हम सारे पेपर्स को पढ़ के उसकी एनालिसिस देते हैं और वो इटसेल्फ एक कंट्रीब्यूशन होता है, उसकी बहुत साइटेशंस आती है. दिस इज कॉल्ड द सिस्टमैटिक लिटरेचर ऑफ रिव्यू एंड दिस इज, ये आपको वैसे ही करना है, ये पीएचडी में आपको वैसे ही करना है, क्योंकि आपको जो है वो सारे पेपर्स पढ़ने हैं. तो जो आप पढ़े वो आप लिखते रहें, वॉट एवर यू आर रीडिंग यू मस्ट राइट इट, एंड एट द एंड ऑफ द डे कम विद द सिस्टमैटिक लिटरेचर रिव्यू व्हिच इज इटसेल्फ इज अ पब्लिकेशन, कैन बी अ पब्लिकेशन, एंड दिस विल गिव यू द नंबर ऑफ द साइटेशन एंड विल हेल्प यू अ लॉट इन पीएचडी डिफेंड. सो देयर इज नो अल्टरनेटिव टू द गुड प्रेजेंटेशन स्टाइल देन दिस. So these are the things that you must know about it. I'm a critical matters. The reference style should be good. Must follow the reference styles of the journals. Some have the APA format. Some journals has a IEEE TR format. Some has the Harvard. A reference style should be critical, and usually the people don't. Organize the references and something is not recognized, it should note that the reason the required, and you should have your paper clear, grammar error free papers. This is very important, I'm telling you, because we are not native English speakers. Koi matlab angrez nahi hai ki hamare jo papers hain wo 100% sahi honge. We are human and we are born to make mistakes. So agar कोई जो है वो नहीं करना चाहता, मतलब नहीं समझ सकता, सही तरीके से नहीं लिख सकता, तो वी हैव इंग्लिश इंग्लिश प्रूफ रीडिंग सर्विसेज. में एक एग्जांपल आपको देता हूं जो कि मैं यूजुअली फॉलो करता हूं. दिस इज अ पेड सर्विस बट व्हिच इज वेरी चीप एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड प्रूफर्स. दिस इज द सर्विस फ्रॉम द यूके एंड दे चार्ज अ फ्यू थाउजेंड, 2-3-4 और मे बी 5,000 और 6,000 रुपीज to completely read your proofread your paper, correct your English. So even my paper is good in English, but I usually forwarded them to make the more consistent English proofreading services before I send it to any impact factor journal, because I don't want to give an impression to the reviewer that the paper is not good in our proofreading services. So this is one of the if anyone want to follow us, this is called proofers.co.uk. okay, and papers from conference, some people publish the paper in the conference, and that of course you can extend the 30% and publish into the journal. That is also a very normal. Conference publications greatly help journal publication, but this trend I have seen that most of the people don't want to publish in the conference, and they would like to publish in the journal. But if you have any previous conference papers and you would like to publish in journal, you can extend 30-40% and write acknowledgement that this is the revised and extended version of the conference paper published in the ABC conference, and then publish in the journal, and this will definitely go. And now we are two more important topics before we end, is that be careful when you reply to reviewer, because when you will publish in an impact factor journal, it will not go in the first go. You will have the reviewers reply to reviewers. You have to reply to reviewers very politely. You need to produce a cover letter, which would be very important. I don't know if I have any cover letter to show to you, but the thing is this. You need to understand that the cover letter is extremely important before you reply to reviewer. Be very, very careful to address the reviewer comments, because when you address the reviewer comments, they will ask you that how actually you have addressed our comments, and then this will help you to get your published paper published very, very quickly. And in this case, what will happen, reviewer will be able to understand that reviewer will be able to understand. For example, I was finding that how to reply the reviewers. For example, this is the example of the reply to reviewers. If we say that, for example, this is the paper, which is like say we say ontology based, whatever paper, we thank for the reviewer that they have accepted the review. And then you see that I'm writing each concern to the reply to the reviewer, that reply the review concern one, and this is the comment from the reviewer, this is my reply, and I told him that the comment has been addressed, is addressed on section, in section one, paragraph number three, and from line number 5 to 19. And then you see I have addressed like this way, reviewer one, then I have addressed reviewer two concern one, reviewer two concern two, reviewer three concern three, and I'm telling every, I'm telling clearly that this is my reply for the journal and the comment is addressed in section one, page number two, paragraph number two, line number 26 to 30. This way we need to tell the reviewer exactly how we have addressed your comments and the revision of the journal paper will come. This way we will avoid the rejection of the paper in a high quality journal. So be careful, will reply to the reviewer, be polite, do not do not reply in haste, think carefully what to write to him, because this is going to be very, very important to reply to reviewer. Okay, so sometimes you know that the right as an author, the decision is not an always. You have a strong portion that if some papers are rejected, you can write to the editor also that our paper has got rejected because of this reason, and this is the possibility to open the door of acceptance. This was also experienced with me that some of the reviewers have rejected the papers because of the baseless reasons, and then we can write to the editor. So now I will go directly to the how to increase the citations, because we are running out of time. How to increase the citation is that there are two ways to increase the citation. One is the good way, one is the bad way. Remember one thing, that whatever I'm presenting in this presentation is purely personal opinion. It is not concluded from anyone's, but it is a personal opinion. So there are two ways, good ways and bad ways. How the people are adopting the bad ways, I'm also going to tell you. What is the good way? The citation increase, write a good paper, submit your paper to the appropriate journal, write an effective title. Title should be very strong. So the search will also be unique. Write a clear abstract. Most of the people do not focus on title, abstract, and keywords. These are the most three important factors for the citation. If you don't focus on the three things, the citations will drop. Write a clear abstract so that your article is appropriately indexed and easy to find. Choose your keywords very, very carefully. I know 90% of the people don't think about keywords. They just write it without thinking. But the keywords are the most important words that will reflect your citation. Make your manuscript available to all readers through open access publications. Put on your website, put on the journal university website, put on the research get, put on Publons, put on Scopus, put on ORCID, whatever the open source are available, wherever, put on. So the people can easily get your article. Believe me, if you Google it and you find it difficult, you will not search it. Okay? Use the social media. So participate in the conference and meetings. Try to create your own website, WordPress, WebPress, these are all free websites. Create your own website, put your papers in, give lectures, talk about your research, and so the people can see your research. So also cite your colleagues, your friend, if it is related. It doesn't mean that your friend is networks and network related field, and you are in software verification, you are citing the network paper. No, cite your colleagues' work related to that, so they can also cite your work, including those with results contrary to your research. Cite your own relevant work. Self-citation. Self-citation is also shows the extension of the work. Read broadly to stay up to date, parallel fields if you have. Subscribe on the Google Scholar, notified. So if there's any paper related to your field, will automatically be in your email. They will inform you that related to this field, the paper has been published. Cite the leaders in your field, like your supervisor or any other people who are doing. So what is the bad way is doing? This is the recently example we have it. Recently, we have published the paper in ABC Journal. And what happened? I received the review and he is telling me, cite an adaptive heuristic, adaptive energy, MEG-REG, and energy wear or VM selection, whatever. What is interesting in this review? This is the review. This is the review concern 6, as I showed you the response to reviewer letter. These all papers belongs to the same reviewers. Same reviewers. See, this Yadav, and somewhere here is also Yadav. All three were papers. So when we are responding to the reviewers, we are afraid. This guy has given me the review and he told me to cite all his papers. Totally inappropriate way. This is not the first time it's happening with me. This is almost 10 or 20 times that I published the papers and I'm facing this same issue. When I face this same issue, I clearly write to the editor that the related work section, these related work section is that we believe that paper 2 and 4 are the most relevant to our work. There we also edit related work and the reference is 4041. And I write to the editor straight away that this reviewer, either he is a Yadav or Zeng. No, none of the other reviewer cannot be. So it is not a blind review. I know who is the reviewer. So these people are actually telling us that how to review and how to increase the citations. This is a very well-known journal with 4.8 impact factor. This is how the people are trying to make their citations high. And this is very normal. This is completely inappropriate way, not acceptable that the reviewers are giving their own citations to increase and unfortunately, the author thinks that if I will not reply them, they will reject my paper. And this is a fear which is a very justifiable. In that case, you can clearly write to the editor in the cover letter that this is the reviewer who suggested us to cite his 4 paper and I have cited 2 because this is the most appropriate. I cannot cite it more because of this reason. So this is all. Thank you very much. And now we are open to the questions. We have lots to talk, but unfortunately the time does not allow us because of already we are done. Thank you so much. Please go ahead if you have any questions.
Thank you very much, sir. It was a very productive session. I mean, I, being a newbie in research field, found your presentation to be very informative. I'm certain all of our viewers also found this session to be very beneficial. I have a couple of questions from our viewers. First of all, I'm going to ask you the first number question. Is there any importance given to renowned clusters or universities by the desk authors or desk editors? Do they prefer some universities or some bunch of authors when reviewing some papers?
Exactly. The more author, you mean that if there are more authors, right? If I'm understanding your question.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes. This is a very important question. And unfortunately, we have seen many Pakistani universities and most of the universities, they are having number of the authors in the paper. To my experience, working with research teams, more than 4 authors or maximum 5 authors is okay. More than 5 authors will, I would consider this thing put your publication in the garbage like this. We have a garbage, put it in that. Okay?
Okay.
Because more authors are actually, what they are doing it, they are losing their credibility. When you will, you know what the university and the people will think? They are trying to compensate the authors. They are trying to giving the benefit to the authors in their promotion, in their funds, or in their different capability, in their different benefits. मैं इसको दोबारा इस तरह repeat करूँगा. जितने ज़्यादा author होंगे, उतनी paper की value कम होगी. ठीक है? Maximum 4 to 5 authors are the most appropriate. If the research is very good, with extensive results, if the paper is around 40 pages, I would go to maximum 6 authors. But I will never support 4 authors in 15 to 20 pages paper, and I will not support more than 6 authors in 30 page paper. This is the answer.
Okay, thank you very much. Because a lot of papers that I have already read that contain more than 5 to 6 authors, and obviously that sets off an alarm in the mind.
Actually, this, as I told you, when you will apply out of, I don't know about the Pakistan, because Higher Education Commission is considering that one or not. But I want to tell you one thing very clearly. आज हमारे पास ये requirement है कि 10 publications हो तो हम associate professor होंगे. 15 publication हो तो full professor होंगे. मैं आपको बता रहा हूँ. कल आपके पास ये requirement थी कि अगर आपके पास 1000 citations होंगी तो आप associate होंगे. 2000 citations होंगी तो आप full professor होंगे. This is coming soon. I'm telling you. And if you are not publishing the high quality paper with less number of articles, you will not reach this goal.
Okay, that is very alarming situation. I'm moving on to the other question. How many chances of acceptance of research papers if journal editors send it to review after preliminary screening? You already told us about ke there are 10 to 15% chances or 15 to 20% chances of different papers, but that is for acceptance, right?
Yeah.
Would my paper go to the review from the editors or not? What are the chances of that?
Okay, so how I will answer this question? This question is like this. Usually in good impact factor journals, when you submit the paper, the editor's desk reject it. They reject it straight away. If your paper is desk rejected, the chances 0%. If your paper gone to review, consider your chances are 20%. If it is for review, if you get revision, major revision, you have the acceptance rate more than 70%. Okay? Agar aapka paper desk reject ho gaya, to baat khatam ho gayi. Agar aapka paper review ke liye chala gaya, to aap ye samjhein ki aapke paas 20 to 25% acceptance ke chance hain. Agar aapka paper review ke baad major revision ke liye aa jata hai, to yakeen karein ki jo paper major revision ke andar aa gaya, उसका रिजेक्शन चांस बहुत कम होता है अनटिल और अनलेस आप मेजर रिवीजन में कोई ब्लंडर ना करें. जिस तरह आपको मैंने बताया, बी केयरफुल रिप्लाइंग टू द रिव्यूअर्स, बी प्रोफेशनल, राइट द कवर लेटर, रिस्पांस क्यूरी. फॉर एग्जांपल द रिव्यूअर आस्क्ड यू 10 क्यूरीज, पुट द क्यूरी नंबर 1 इनटू द कवर लेटर, 2, 3, 4, आंसर वन बाय वन. आई हैव एड्रेस्ड योर क्यूरी दिस वे, आई हैव एड्रेस्ड योर क्यूरी दिस वे, एंड राइट इन द बॉटम, I have tried my level best to answer your queries. Still, if you are not satisfied, you are most welcome to give us another revision and we can reply out. Your paper will go second revision. Agar wo second revision ke pass aata hai, consider it as 100% accepted.
All right, thank you. One last question, sir. What if any of the suggested papers by reviewers are not relevant to site? How author is supposed to respond in this case? What if the reviewers say that you have to cite this paper, but that is not relevant in your case?
This is what exactly I say. For this, we have a email address on the bottom of the site. Actually, this is what I told you, that this is the way of the increasing the citations, and the most of the reviewers like Publons to increase their session in Publons and. strictly reported to the editor. Okay. And you know what the editor will do? Editor will not send your paper to the reviewer back again. Okay. Again, you will write the reviewer that this reviewer has given us the paper. How you will write it? You will write it. The paper is a blind rear editor. Thank you very much for your review reports that we have got it. We highly appreciate the reviewer comments, and we are completely agree that the reviewer comments are very constructive and it will definitely improve our paper. But unfortunately, one of the reviewer has suggested that please cite this paper. Which authors think that this paper is not relevant? We are afraid that we are going to add this paper into review, what you reference in our paper. This will affect the integrity of our paper, and as well, this will be out of the scope. Therefore, we are in a in a mind that this is the reviewer who has given the paper. Therefore, we would like to request you to we cannot add this reference. And we would like to request you to obsolete this reviewer, and it will be done. Don't do it.
Right. Thank you very much for this informative session. It was an honor to have you on board. And I'm sure on behalf of all the SMUTA members, and the Islam University students and teachers associations, and all of the people that attended this session, I thank you for giving us time and gracing us with your impeccable knowledge. And thank you very much for giving us time, sir. Thank
okay.
you very much.
So I would just say that thank you very much, Dr. Bhabeh. Actually, you can, I don't know if there is my, you can give my email address, and I already showed my web. My email address is available on the web. And if anybody like to have this presentation, or if anybody would like to go for, selecting the journal or appropriate journal, if we face any problem for selecting the journal, right journal, or if he faces any issue related to the reviewing reports or all other, as a Pakistani national, I'm open to my community, although I'm not living in Pakistan, but you're most welcome to communicate with me through email, and I will try my level best to respond as much as I can. Thank you very much.
That is so great. That is so great of you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.